Tonight on Access TV, live, live, with Gotham Comedy, live. Get ready to laugh. With Joe DeRosa, Mark Norman, Greer Barnes, Ophira Eisenberg, and your host, Mario Cantone.
That's a lot of information, but I shouldn't even be telling you that because you're watching.
From the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, live, all happening right now. Ladies and gentlemen, your host, Mario Cantone.
Welcome to Gotham Comedy Live. It's Gotham, not Gotham. It's Gotham Comedy here on Access TV. Access. I say Access. It's the brand new cable station. It's not a gay porn station. It's Access. Why do women in porn do that? Can you please tell me what the... girls with the small tits because they're like, okay, one more take, keep going, I'm gonna get it, keep going, I'm almost there, let me try this one, it's a little bigger. We don't go like this. Makes no sense. Oh my gosh, well, I'm glad there's a good live comedy show on TV now because I'm getting a little tired of the reality shows. Do you watch the reality shows? Because I can't do it. The Kardashians, I just want to, who? What do you do? Where is your talent? What? I hate Bruce Jenner with that nose. He's like, he's terrifying. And the names, Chloe and Courtney and Kim and cholera and chlamydia and gonorrhea. I hate them. I am watching American Idol, though. It came back last week, right? I do. I'm very obsessed with the American Idol, even though it's becoming about the judges, huh? That's, I know, with Nicki Minaj and her cotton candy. She's like, how are you, sweetheart? How are you? Poor ladybug, what's your name, sweetheart? And Mariah's like, shut the fuck up. Yeah, they're not getting along. Mariah, though, she has experience. She is a singer, even though she draws every note she sings. Do you ever see when she's like, I don't need a love for Gridman. Put the crayon down! She could dress a little. I mean, her boobs, and one's going this way, the other one's going this way. She looks like a fucking Picasso. But she's got the experience to be a judge. The judges, though, it's become about the judges. I miss Paula. I liked Paula Abdul every week, just watching her go. Steven Tyler last year had nothing. He had nothing to say. He had nothing to say. That's all he did was go. You can't pick the cherries with your back to the tree. You know what you did? You went down the street, you went into the house, you got a ladder, you went up on the roof, you put out a fire, you came back down the kitchen, you baked a cake, you delivered it across the street, you blew out the candles, you came back, you blew me, you blew her. Out of control. Yeah, well, it's a legit show, though. I like because it produces stars. It does. It does. I mean, you could talk about The Voice. No one's coming off the... And I can't... I love CeeLo. I love his voice, but I can't watch that chair. And he's like, can you reach the button? I can't. And Christina Jabba, the La Hera, I can't with her either. I just, no, I like American Idol. There's some real people that came out of there, I think so. Oh my God, New York City, look at the skyline, isn't it beautiful? I love my set. I live in New York City, and I take the subway every day. I take the subway, I do, I do. And even like, you know, during the terror codes, remember the codes we had? The orange, blue, green, it was a rainbow of terror. Yellow, what was yellow? The city smells like urine, but everything's okay. Oh, and the people, you know, there's still the fear once in a while. I think you get, but I'm not afraid. I'm like, here's my Metro card, blow me up. Blow me the fuck up. Blow me up to the Bronx. Blow me down to Brooklyn. Just fucking blow me up. Blow me. Beep, beep, beep. Please swipe again. Please swipe again. Please swipe again. What's happening? No, I'm not afraid. I just do it. I just take that subway. They're going to blow it up. No, they're not. Yeah, they're going to blow it up. They're going to spray cyanide. When? Yeah, they're going to spray cyanide. Let me tell you something. If you smell toasted almonds, there's a peanut vendor upstairs. What's the difference? Because I don't, I tell you, the cabs, I'm so impatient in a cab. I am like Faye Dunaway in the back of a cab. I'm like, I told you to go up 6th Avenue and across 44th Street. Why do you defy me? Drive, go around the bus, go around the bus, drive, and shut this glass partition. It stinks in here. Ugh. That tree is doing nothing. Is it a curry tree? How about having lunch 24 hours before you go to work? And the music they play in the cabs, like, shut it off! I'm terrified enough as it is! I mean, look, I know we're supposed to accept the cultures of other nationalities and religions, I know, but let me tell you something, this shit blows. You can't dance to it. Are there lyrics? I want to go to the store to get some vegetables and put them in a cabinet. And then every time I get in a cab, they're always on the phone. Always. Say, hi, excuse me, I like... Sir, excuse me, I want to... Sir, who are you talking to? Who are you talking to? You're plotting! You're plotting! Give me that! Osama, he is working! Drive! Yeah. Oh my God. Yes, well, you know, they got him though, Mr. Bin Laden. How about they killed him? How weird is that? They killed him. And he was watching TV. He was. What was he watching? I just wanted, he's probably like watching some porn. He's like, oh, God. I'll miss him. I'll miss Mr. Bin Laden. I really will. I'll miss those videos he would send us. Great videos in front of the rocks, remember? And he'd be holding that microphone with his pinky extended like he was singing a Whitney Houston ballad. It's like, Allah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allah, Salaam alaykum, Allah. This is going to be a great evening. We have a great show tonight. We'll be right back with more Gotham Live right here on Access TV right after this.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV. Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, Mark Norman is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
Welcome back. Welcome back to Gotham Comedy Live. Oh my goodness. Our first comedian is a young man that I just met this evening, and I think you may have seen him on, isn't that hilarious? A young man that I just met this evening. You may have seen him on Comedy Central, and he's just scratching the surface, and here he is tonight, Mr. Mark Norman.
Good to be here. This is fun, huh? Yeah, boy. All right. Boy, a lot of hot gals here, I'll tell you that. Well, not you, but a couple are pretty hot, I'll tell you. You guys are boozing. That's cool. Drink up. Go nuts. I like to drink. I've got a bit of a problem. I got really drunk last night. Was incredibly hungover today. Had another beer. Hangover went away. Isn't that the amazing thing about booze? The thing that causes the problem is also the solution, you know? I wish other problems were like that. You know, like you have sex with a girl, she gets pregnant, fuck her again, no more baby. Oh, man. Oh, boy. That would be amazing. Then you're guaranteed to get laid at least twice. Now you're talking, we're like, woo, last night was incredible, we should do that again. Nah, I think I'm gonna go home. Hey, I'm just being responsible. Isn't that crazy? It's 2013. We still can't prevent a hangover. I get the worst hangovers of all time. We can prevent childbirth, but we can't prevent a hangover. What is that? At least some people want kids. You'll never hear anybody say, oof, I'm pretty hungover, but you know what? I think I want to keep it. Never hear it. Yeah, I go to a lot of bars. My friend actually works at a gay bar, so I'll go there from time to time, get a free drink, maybe a compliment. And you know, my guy friends are blown away by this. They're like, dude, you go to gay bars? That is weird. If some gay guy ever hit on me, I don't know what I would do. How about you just not fuck him? Seems pretty easy. Never got it. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. Sometimes I wish I was gay. Seems pretty good, you know? Just a couple of mimosas, decorating, you know? That's all right. But big fan of the gals. Love the ladies. You know, you can't help what you like. Love the ladies, which is weird. guy wasn't half Irish, he'd get all the floats, you know? Save some for the rest of us, buddy. But yeah, I love the ladies, but you gals are a tough nut to crack. Can I say that? Very complex. You're all different, you know? Like, some girls like a nice guy. Some girls like jerks. So how do you know? You know? What I do both. I see an attractive lady, I open the door for her, and I say, after you, fatty. Mix it up, cover your bases, you know? Hold from column A, from column B. Keep them guessing, you never know. I think women get the short end of the stick on the whole sex game. You know, guy has sex with a lot of girls, he's a cool guy. Girl has sex with a lot of guys, everybody makes fun of her. I hate when guys pull this move. They go, hey, you know, I had sex with that girl, I'm the man. And you go, well, she had sex with him too. And they go, oh, what a slut. Well, how come she's a slut now? How come she wasn't a slut when she had sex with you? You never hear a guy say that. Whew, she fucked me. What a whore. Wow, that's gross. You've got some problems. Get your shit together, all right? This is a wake-up call, okay? Come on. We're so mean to promiscuous girls in this society, you know? Slut, whore, she's loose, she's easy, what a skank. Why are we so mean to these girls? Don't we all like sex? Why are we getting mad at the one group giving it away? Yeah? Yeah, we all like Banana Republic, but if they have a sale, nobody calls them a whore. Yeah? I don't get it. We got a black president now, gay marriage is legal here, yet sluts are still oppressed. That's the one group in this country that still gets stepped on, and I'm the only guy sticking up for these women, all right? Yeah. Yeah, come on. Yeah, even women won't stick up for them. Those sluts will ruin it for everybody. No, you could put out two. Please do, come on. I genuinely don't understand it. I feel like if we're gonna make fun of a group of women, let's make fun of the prude girls, right? They're the boring, annoying ones. Let's kick them off their high horse. Why do we reward these women, you know? I don't have sex till 3 months into a relationship. Yeah, because you have nothing else to offer. Get a personality together. Come on, kick it up a notch. Let's move it along. Because let's be honest, prude girls, they're like mom and pop shops. We all pretend to like them, but they're more expensive and they close early. All right? Yeah. Promiscuous girls are like Walmart. All right? When they move into a neighborhood, everybody starts complaining. But at 4 a.m, when you're in a pinch, you're glad they're there. Yeah. All right. I just want to point out that joke is pro-women, by the way, all right? Everybody take it easy. My favorite kind of gal, I love Jewish women. That's my number one. Oh, yeah, hey. Shalom, how are you? I love a Jewish gal. I don't know what it is, you guys drive me wild. I don't care about the religion part. I just love a big Jew face on a lady. I can't get enough. I was actually lucky enough to date a Jewish girl for a while. We talked about getting married, and her dad made us break up because I'm not Jewish. And I was like, come on, really? Seriously? Like, I live in New York, I have curly hair, I'm circumcised, I'm a comedian, I'm like, right there. Oh. But still, he was like, no, my daughter will only marry a Jew. I want my people to live on, I want my culture to live on. Jews are all about living on. That's when I thought, man, Jews must be really jealous of gay people. Because gay people can't even reproduce, yet they keep popping up. That's amazing. That's incredible. No other group can do that. It's like a superpower, you know? You're like, Jews are sitting around like, you gotta marry a Jew, you gotta marry a Jew, and gays are like, we'll be fine. Thanks a lot, guys. I'm Mark Norman. Have a good night.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Ophira Eisenberg is taking the stage when we return.
Welcome back to Gotham Comedy Live. I'm Mario Cantone. Oh, Access TV. This is brand new. It's real tits and ass, supposedly. I'm gay, so fuck you. All right, so you need a little bit of banana. All right, so I just called myself a fruit. Our next comedian That's what we call them years ago, comedians, and I'd like to bring that back, is a lovely, lovely young lady that I just met tonight also, and I had sex with her. It didn't work out, but I really tried. You've seen her on Comedy Central and VH1. Here she is, Ophira Eisenberg.
My name is Ophira Eisenberg. That is not a joke. Or as I was introduced in Texas, Oprah something Jewish. Best they could do. And I love people that are so overconfident with my name, they don't even try. I was at a party, met this girl, I was like, hey, my name's Ophira. She goes, do you mean Ophelia? Yes, of course, I always forget my own fucking name. What is it again? Stranger? Ophelia. Thank you. Thank you. I'll remember that. Just before I came here tonight, my husband insulted me. He said, you are never happy with what you have. You are always looking for the next thing. I was like, well, we'll see what my second husband thinks about that. So. And then he called me passive aggressive. He called me passive aggressive, and I told him to go fuck himself in an email. Saved in drafts. But he'll find it. He'll find it. I got married later than a lot of my friends, so I actually thought my marriage was gonna be better than theirs. That is hilarious. I thought I was gonna be in a unique marriage, different than everybody else's. Stupid, you end up in the same marriage as every other couple. You cannot escape the stereotype. I get it. And if I was out there dating again, next time, I am asking different questions, okay? I'm not gonna be like, what kind of music do you like? What's your favorite movie? I'm just gonna ask, do you put your shit away? You walk into the door. You have a jacket, hat, and bag. Walk me through what happens next. And I'd end up with someone, I'd be like, he cheats on me. Oh, he gambles, yeah, he beats me, but he's tidy. Who cares? He's a dreamboat. My husband is a comic book nerd, but very good looking. And that is a great combination, right? Low self-esteem, but attractive. Get him! And we live in Brooklyn. When I moved to Brooklyn, my family's in Canada, and my sister goes, I know Canadians, it's good, it's good. You're all here. Very excited. I say our greetings, sorry. That is like shalom in Canadian. But she goes, you're moving to Brooklyn. Brooklyn is very dangerous. She goes, are there crackheads in your neighborhood? There are no crackheads in my neighborhood. If anyone's doing crack in my neighborhood, they're doing like organic, free range crack. You know, like low carb, omega 3 crack. That they buy at the Whole Crack. It's a beautiful store, Whole Crack. Oh my God. Goes well with a Malbec, beautiful, very nice, seasonally. I do not do drugs anymore. I can't handle it. As I got older, I can't handle it. Like, I used to like smoking pot, but it would make me paranoid. And when I used to get paranoid, I'd be like, oh my God, are you guys my friends? But now I'm like, my taxes! Like, that's where I'm at. Like, is that the IRS? Run, run! And someone offered me ecstasy after a show recently, and I was like, what? No! And they were like, why not? I was like, why not? Well, for one, I don't have 2 weeks cleared off on either side of today, you know? Okay, I need that planned in advance. I need to know where there's a meadow, Like, plus, I can't imagine doing ecstasy with my current group of friends. Like, what are we gonna do? Get high and then be like, let's play with your baby! Like, what are we gonna do? I say my husband is a big nerd, yet I had no idea to what extent. So this is what happened. I walked into the room and he slammed down his laptop, right? Slammed down and then went like this. Hi! Is there anything more guilty than that? I was like, what are you looking at? He was like, nothing, nothing, vacation options. And he is a smart guy, but I know he is not smart enough to clear his browser. So the next day when he is not there, but his laptop is there, I open it up and I've got my finger on the touchpad because I am gonna find out what porn this guy is looking at. But I froze because I was like, do I really wanna know this? I know, and I know for sure he's not looking at pictures of girls that look like me, right? Like he's not buying Jewy brunettes. With upper thigh issues. Gone wild. He's not downloading the porn. Bangs. Which does exist. That is a real porn. It's just a bunch of girls trying to make their way through hair school. No. I'm his wife. He's looking at the opposite of me, right? He's looking at big, blonde, busty Christians who can't get enough. Because he knows I can get enough. But who can stop themselves from an answer that is one click away? No one. So I brought up the last website he had viewed, and I started reading it, and I was like, what the fuck is this? Because it was a website called MuggleCast. That is a website for Harry Potter enthusiasts. That is what that is. That is so scary. I was like, my problem isn't other women, it's other wizards. Like, what the fuck do I do with that? Here I'm buying French lingerie to spice things up. Wrong. I need a big Hogwarts scarf and a robe and to learn the rules to Quidditch or something. When I climax, I should go Expialis or some shit. I don't know. You guys have been awesome. Thank you so much.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Joe DeRosa is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
Welcome back to Gotham Comedy Live on Access TV. Our next comic I met tonight, and he's a bright young man. I feel like I'm 90, and they're like, these boys are just so bright and young and fresh. I just love them. He has appeared on the Opie and Anthony show, which I had too. What happened to them? And Comedy Central also. He's a great guy and he's so funny. Please welcome Mr. Joe DeRosa.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Anybody else in here getting miserably depressed? Good. Good. I gotta tell you a story. I'm gonna do the whole thing, one story. So jump the fuck in or you're shit out of luck. I get really depressed. And when I get depressed, I depression eat, okay? And my food of choice is KFC. So when I get bummed out, I go to KFC, I get the family picnic bucket. And I eat it all day until it's gone. That's all I do for the whole day. I take the day off with the bucket. So, I go to KFC recently. I'm feeling like shit. I walk in. It sucks immediately, because as soon as you walk up and go, I'd like the family picnic bucket, the guy gives you a look like, you don't have a girlfriend, do you? Because it's 10 pieces, 2 large sides, 4 biscuits. That's what it is. So I order it, and I go, for my 2 sides, I'd like mashed potatoes with gravy and coleslaw, please. And you know what? Keep the biscuits. I don't eat them. And he goes, well, do you want another large side then? That's what he said. And I said, don't fuck with me right now. I'm in a dark place. And he goes, no, I'm not fucking with you, man. You gotta get something for that biscuit money. Which, that sounds like something a pimp would say. So he goes, get another large side. So I'm like, Jesus, this is getting a little ridiculous here. Give me the green beans. Let's add some health into the mix here. Which, if you ever had the green beans at KFC, worthless. Zero nutritional. They're green straws and water. That's all it is. But I order them. Then he goes, hey man, you want original recipe or extra crispy? And I say, mix it up. I want to be surprised every time I reach into the bucket. He goes, great, you want some grilled too? Do you want me to kick you in your fucking face right now? Did anybody say grilled? I said I want to be surprised pleasantly. So he goes, no problem, coming right up. He walks away, he comes right back. He goes, dude, listen, man, we're out of extra crispy. Do you mind waiting 10 minutes? I got to make some more. I say, no problem. Mistake, for a number of reasons, which you'll find out. But the first mistake is you don't want time to sit in KFC. You just don't. You don't want time to contemplate what it is you're about to do to yourself, all right? But I agree to wait, so now I'm sitting in KFC, and I got that same feeling I have when I'm drunk and I go to a massage parlor, you know? Should I be doing this right now? Do these girls even want to be here? Are they slaves? Oh my God, am I going to get a hand job from a slave? This is terrible. What am I doing? This is terrible. Oh, I'm up? Okay, great. Thank you. Awesome. Thank you. He comes out after a few minutes, he goes, hey man, hey buddy, you want a soda? It's on me. And I go, why? And he goes, because I feel bad that you're waiting here, man. I go, dude, I was gonna drink nothing but water to offset this sodium avalanche that's about to come into my body. An IV of Gatorade couldn't compensate for the rock salt in chicken form I'm about to eat. Now you want to bring sugar into the mix? Are you out of your fucking mind? Yeah, I'll take one. Fuck it, I'm here. So he gives me a soda. I'm drinking it, a few more minutes goes by. Then he goes, hey buddy, you're up, I got you. So I walk to the counter and I do the checklist as he loads the bag. I watch him load the bag. You gotta do the checklist, man. Cause do you ever order fast food and you get home and they forgot something? Like, you wanna murder somebody when that happens. You're all excited, you're like, yeah, I'm gonna eat my shit, cocksucker! So, I watch him load the bag. I'm like, chicken, check. Mashed potatoes, check. Coleslaw, check. Green beans, check. Then he goes, hey buddy, we're gonna give you some potato wedges. Sorry again about that wait. Stop it! Puts potato wedges in, then he puts the box of biscuits into the bag too. He gave me the biscuits and the biscuit money. I'm like, fuck, man, I don't want those biscuits. But I have sulking to do. I don't have time to argue with this guy right now. I'm like, fuck it, I gotta go. So I take this shit home. I skip home with my food. I get home, sweatpants go on. Yeah. There will be nappings in between the feedings. And I lay this shit out all over my coffee table. And I start getting down. Down. I'm E-N with an apostrophe. All right? I'm like chicken, blah. Coleslaw, mashed potatoes. Potato wedges, taking them, dipping them into the mashed potatoes. Yeah. Look, I call that a speedball, okay? Green beans, get the fuck out of here. What was I thinking? And I put a dent in the shit, and I'm full. I'm full, like. And just as my eyes are rolling back into my head, I have a thought. I think I will have a biscuit. Why not? We're here. I lean forward, I pick up the unopened box of biscuits. I'm like, this feels heavier than biscuits. What's going on? I open it up, more chicken! He gave me 5 extra pieces of chicken! That's how fucking sorry this guy felt for me! And he didn't even tell me about it! It was his way of flirting with me quietly from a distance. As if he was taking a picture of his pussy and emailing it to me while I was at work. Like, I know what you like, big boy. Extra crispy. Thanks a lot, guys. You're great. Thank you. Have a good night. Thank you.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV. Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, Greer Barnes is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
Welcome back to Gotham Comedy Live. Right here on Access TV, I had a feather in my mouth. This next guy I've known for years, and when he was younger, between his looks and his talent, I wanted him so badly, but now he's past his prime. But he's here tonight, and I adore him, and he's so brilliant and hilarious. Please welcome Mr. Greer Barnes. Mr. Greer Barnes.
Yay. How y'all doing? Okay, cool. I'm actually not a comic. I was at the bar. And they asked me if I wanted to make $5 real quick. Like, I ain't gotta take my pants off, right? Not this time, silly. So anyway, I was in the park last night chasing this white guy. You guys aren't too fast, but you run a really long time. I would have had to have been Kenyan to catch this dude. I mean, run right next to him. What type of shoes are those? These rocks are hurting my feet. Okay, I see you at the finish line. That's the sound brothers make when they run. You hear that? It's a brother running. Mommy, what's that? Black guy running. Mommy, what's that? Rest of the basketball team. USA's men's Olympic basketball team kicked the shit out of the world. Did you see the French when they saw us coming? The French were like, holy shit, the niggas are coming, run. Hide the women. Did you see the English? The English are like, well, no one told us they could fly. Is that legal? Are they allowed to do that? I thought you had to dribble, perhaps pass it, then maybe take, there he goes again. Look at that, just. With their dicks in our faces, this isn't good. And what they did to the Nigerians was just wrong. Beat them by 86 points. Poor Nigerians, they had no clue. They were running in the wrong direction. Passing the ball to the USA team. Arguing amongst themselves. Why did you pass the ball to him? Because from this angle, he looks a lot like you, okay? All I saw was his nose. So in my mind, I am thinking this has to be Umakwekwe. So I pass it. And to both of our surprise, it was Kobe, okay? With his dick in our face. I'm a big fan of Barack Obama. I know a lot of people don't like him, and I... and I call these people white. Not all white people, just them Tea Party people. I'm sitting home one night smoking a joint watching C-SPAN, right? Fuck y'all laughing at? I got cable. Like, he has cable. I'm sitting there watching C-SPAN, and this woman gets up there. She's really distraught. She's on the verge of tears. She's like, just give us back our country. We just want our country back. And I'm like, somebody took us? Well, where we at? Who got us, China? That's right, bitches, and we keep you in this pocket. No offense to my Asian brothers and sisters. I don't want y'all waiting for me outside. Hey, Mr. Brown Guy. Why don't you tell us joke now, huh? Damn. This one Tea Party dude tried to blame the whole oil spill in the Gulf of Mexico. Took place a few years back. Tried to blame it on Barack. Wanted to call him a nigga too. I could hear it. Just by the way he spoke when he got up there, he's like, this whole ordeal is taking place in the Gulf of Mexico. Is that man's fault? Mr. President, you need to get down there and fix it. How about you go do your job? Really? Barack supposed to fix it? Like Barack gonna be underwater like, I did it, Michelle. And I bought some petroleum back for your hair, in case you... Yeah, okay. You guys have been fantastic. Good night. Bye.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
What a great evening. Thank you for being here. Let's have another hand for our great comics tonight. Mark Norman, Ophira Eisenberg, Joe DeRosa, and Greer Barnes. Thank you very much, everybody. This was fantastic. Have a great night. Join us again next week, right here on Gotham Comedy Live on Axe Ass TV. You're a fantastic New Yorker.